JRA 501. This is a photograph of the SONGS facility in San Clemente, California. SONGS stands for San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station. So, I went to the NRC public meeting review regarding the restart program that they're trying to push without getting relicensed, without anything. So they tried to slide all this through and it backfired on them, and now we're putting pressure on the NRC to do the right thing, which they should have done in the beginning. Heaven forbid. So here's a photograph of the meeting. It was held in a little church. That didn't seem to stop anybody from lying through their teeth. And you can clearly see all of the people here that are in orange. Those people represent the Laborers Union 89 of San Diego. So what was interesting was, while I did a video on this, while I was up taking a picture of the facility, I noticed this rally going on, and all of these people were bussed in. There had to have been like 10 buses. And they fed them. They gave them a little goodie bag. And the people that drove themselves were given compensation for driving. So I've never been around any union workers or anything, so I had no clue how this all works. And apparently, through conversations that I had with people there that were in orange shirts, things really weren't as they were being portrayed. So I'm going to show a little video here, kind of speaks for itself.
All right, thank you. We have a question, Val Masedo.
Oh yes, my name is Val Masedo. I'm the business manager of Laborers International Union of North America, Local 89. I speak for the laborers in this house, these brothers and sisters in the orange I proudly represent. And I'm here to ask you, members that have worked there, please raise your hand if you know it's safe.
Okay, right here, you're going to see him coax these people into saying and doing what he wants.
Everybody should be raising their hand.
Everybody should be raising
this power
their
plan
hand.
Is.
Everybody should
also
be raising their hand.
Also, we represent other contractors in different sectors of the industry, and they are safe. But it doesn't even compare to what goes on at San Onofre Power Plant.
So right here, it doesn't even compare to what is going on at San Onofre. Lie, lie, lie. This is the extent at which Southern California Edison will push, busing in hundreds of people, having them consume the entire room, and they had to actually have an overflow room, and that was all filled with civilians because they couldn't fit in.
This is the safest place that our members can work. My father's retired from there. My sisters have worked there for many years, along with many other brothers and sisters that we represent. It is a safe environment. Please. All these numbers that are being thrown out today by different politicians, that sounds great. But who is here today? I ask you to please follow your process and let's start this plant up and respect these workers that work in a safe environment and let's put them back to work. Thank you.
Okay. That was actually kind of funny. So here's different angles. I sat all over the whole room. At one point, I went to the restroom and spoke with a Mexican lady. And I told her, I said, you know, there is no you or me. We're all on the same side. You need to understand that this plant is not safe for you to work in. And they're lying to you about that. And I said, do you have children or grandchildren? And she said, yes. I said, well, for their sake, be smart, do some research, and find out for yourself, because you're being lied to. She leaned over to me and pretty much whispered that there's an awful lot of people here who are not in the union, but they're here to support the union. Okay? So that was my first encounter, one of several that I had that evening. Here's another photograph. Now, where I live, our local county prison pretty much has these same colors. Now, I do agree that they do stand out very nicely, and if this was a crew working, you would definitely want to identify who was part of your crew on a job. I get that. I'm not saying, you know, that these people shouldn't go back to work. They should. But it's up to the union to find them work. It's also up to the union to provide them with a safe working environment. That is what is on their own website. So as you can see, many of these people are older, and I would say half of these people did not speak English. So I was also told that there were people in the crowd that were taking photographs to make sure that these people in the orange were doing what they were supposed to do. They were all coaxed into doing clapping on command, and it was totally a staged event, which makes me really sad, because these people had no clue what they were doing. Also, I sat next to a young man who didn't have a clue what was going on, didn't understand anything. I told him to just sit and listen. And I said, he kept asking me questions. And I said to him, I asked him, do you have children? No. I said, do you have family that lives in, you know, San Diego County? And he said, yes. And I said, well, if you're working on this site, wouldn't you want to make sure that you were safe? I'm sure your family would want you to be safe. I said, and the other thing is if they restart this, it's not if, but when this something catastrophic will happen at this plant. And all they want to do is roll the dice and see what they can get away with, because they don't care about you. They don't care about me. They care about profits before people. Bottom line. And he leaned over and he said, again, there are many people here who do not work for the union. There are many people here who were brought in to support the union. So, I've never known anything about unions. But this, to me, is absolutely appalling. Absolutely appalling. The amount of money that was spent on bringing these people in, and all of their jefe workers, you know, the big boys, the bosses, all stood up and demanded that they put these people back to work at a place that is safe. You know, it almost makes me depressed, but it also makes me so much more aware of the depth and the magnitude in which people will go to when they are a slave to a dollar bill, and that is what they worship. As always, God bless.